Hello, YouTube family. Greg D here with TGN, and we are back with another DCUO video. So, we are back once again with our munitions DPS, our main character, terrorizing. Some of the things that I did off camera were, I believe that I got, yes, I did. So, I got our neck piece up to level 9. Actually, level, I can break through, but I still need two more catalyst here, and I need one more there, which you can see here. So I currently have 64 justice tokens. I need 35 and one, and I think this resets after like so many days. The ingots are there, so that was number one. If you remember from the last episode too, I believe I did show you that we did level up Nubia, but I need one more level with her to unlock her first support ability. Let me see, what's Cyborg's support? Receive bonus to passive power recovery. Okay, so he's power recovery. But I need to get her up to level 4. Before we can do anything regarding, what's the word I'm looking for? So I can equip her, basically. So there was that. We got the tier 2 pet. We did discuss possibly getting, like, the Batman Who Laughs as another ally, just to kind of see about that. So first things first, though, we need to open our daily rewards and see what we got today. So we got source marks and a piece of gear. Before we get too far into the video, of course, if you guys could do me a huge solid favor and hit that subscribe button if you haven't already, hit that notification bell as well, get notified of all the videos. And of course, as we slowly but surely work our way towards 10,000 subscribers, hit that like button, help other people see the videos that I post through DCUO, and we'll eventually get there. So let's claim all the source marks. So that's an extra 10. And then I want to save my fate tokens to get so I can buy the whatchamacallit. Buy the God, I can't think today. The styles. Now I do have some things here as well that I can use, and another part of me as well wants to start buying the pieces of gear, obviously, because the pieces of gear are pretty nice. Oh, I did manage to get with a group and beat Black Manta off camera as well, hence why you see the Lady Blackhawk here thing done. But that's basically the same thing as the Cyborg thing. You get 8 source marks, 8 justice tokens, and you get a large loot cache for that. So let's get our free mark.
Yes, you will be handsomely rewarded.
Yep, I'm sure I will be. So one thing I want to do real quick is I want to go to my base. And what the hell? I want to go to the base and I want to put in that new might generator mod there. Oh, and one thing that we should talk about, and I'm not sure if you guys have seen this, but the developers of DCUO, like the company that's in charge of developing DCUO at this point, I can't remember what the heck their name is. Let me look at this real quick. Hold on a second. Let me find it here online real quick. Because there was something that I wanted to tell you guys, and I forget where I saw it. So, I know some of us in the chat have been talking about like Marvel, they're coming out. I literally can't talk today. I don't know what my problem is. They are coming out with a Marvel MMO RPG, much like DCUO, and it is based on the developers from DCUO. So, is in the works at Dimensional Inc., which is the studio behind DCUO and the subsidiary of Daybreak Games. The game's development will be led by Jack Emmert, who designed City of Heroes and who currently leads development on DCUO. So it says here that, blah, 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 and I'm sure you know, guys have talked about this, but I just kind of wanted to cover this real quick while we were talking about this. So it looks like the project is long term, so don't expect to hear more until 2023. I guess the big thing, the big news from Dimensional Inc., Daybreak, DCUO, is that the first thing they're going to do is they're going to make a huge upgrade. Like, I guess DCUO is going to be getting a huge overhaul. It says DCUO is scheduled to get an upgrade, a graphics upgrade, and the largest expansion content to date, scheduled for 2023. So at some point next year, DCUO is going to be getting some kind of like huge freaking graphics update. I don't know what that means necessarily. I'm kind of curious to see what that does mean. And like a complete overhaul. I'm wondering if maybe the whole overhaul with how they did with episode 41 might be just like the first little piece of that. First little sprinkling of that. But like a huge graphics and the largest expansion like set to date. That's crazy. So I don't know what that means. There's not really a whole lot of news from what I can see on that. I mean, correct me if I'm wrong in the comment section below. But I mean, that's huge. So not this year, next year sometime, possibly longer. I mean, it is just, you know, January 1st at this point, unfortunately, but let's see. Da, 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 da. Need might. So let's see what the difference is here. So might 1100 might. This is 1300 might. Okay. But anywho, so yes, DCUO is getting a huge graphics update in 2023. I'm sure we probably won't have any news on that until later this year. But also the big news, like I said, because some of us have talked about it, like in the comment section here in the last couple of videos, is that the same company that makes DCUO will or is, I guess technically, working on a Marvel version of DCUO, which is crazy. And now we probably won't get any kind of news until next year. And that's just the news. I mean, it's probably safe to say that something like a Marvel MMO probably won't even come out until 2024, maybe 2025. I mean, we're probably talking several years before we're even close to anything like that, honestly. So, you know, don't get your hopes up that this is going to be something that's coming out like soon, because it's probably not. But I mean, are they going to take? I'm sure that some stuff will carry over just because it's the same developers, you know what I mean? So, like, and I'm sure that the whole upgrade and update that they're going to do to DCUO before the Marvel one comes out will probably affect the Marvel one. And what I mean by that is maybe the graphics update that DCUO is going to have will obviously be the graphics that we'll see in the new Marvel one. Ooh, I got 500 ally there, favor there. That's cool. So the new graphics that we'll get from DCUO, we'll probably see in Marvel. I don't know necessarily, and it's really hard to say, but I would imagine that the Marvel MMO would look similar. I mean, it might not be exactly the same, but it probably will look pretty similar, I would imagine. I mean, it's kind of hard to say that it wouldn't, since the same fucking developers. Honestly. But I'm really excited for the Marvel MMO just because it could be something. Maybe what they'll do. Maybe what they'll do is they'll actually listen to some of the stuff, that we've been wanting for years. And maybe I can almost guarantee that it's going to be set up the same, like they'll have a story mode to get you started. And it'll probably be set up the same exact way that DCUO is set up right now. You'll probably have like it's a Marvel universe, so I don't even necessarily know how you would do it, but you could maybe go like my first thought is you could choose whether you wanted to be like a mutant. So maybe like Professor X is your mentor on the hero side. Magneto is your mentor on the villain side. So you could maybe do a mutant. Maybe you could be like a. So I mean that, and then that way you could cover like, if you wanted to be someone like Spider-Man or Wolverine or any of the X-Men, Cyclops. I don't even know how you would do that. I don't know why I'm thinking mutants, but. I mean, then the Marvel thing could be like, I wonder if you could be like could you have like godly powers? So maybe you could have someone like Thor on the, like magic side. You know what I mean? Like I'm wondering if you could almost have if they would almost do like a meta magic and tech like they do with DCUO. Like a tech could be like your Iron Man on the hero side and your God, who the fuck knows on the villain side. I can't even think of anybody right now. Tech could be, Iron Man, Daredevil. Meta could be someone like a mutant. Magic could be someone like Thor, someone like tech could be even someone like the Hulk. I guess technically, because he's a scientist and he used gamma rays to whatever, but I know I'm kind of getting lost in that, but I'm really kind of excited now, even though I probably shouldn't be, because we're talking about something that's gonna be 2, 3, 4 years from now. But I guess the exciting thing about all of that as well is that DCUO is going to benefit from this as well because, again, big graphics update, which who knows? What does that mean? Does that mean that, like, the game's totally going to look different from what it does now? I mean, over time they've added new skins for characters and the superheroes and the villains and all this stuff, but, like, what does that mean? What does that mean? What are we going to get? What are we going to get? I know I've been rambling now for the last. What, probably 10 minutes about this, but it's exciting to me to see what exactly they're going to do. And hopefully by then I'll have my hands on a PlayStation 5, of course, because I have now been waiting since DC or since PlayStation 5 came out. Or was initially released back in what, fall of 2020? I have been waiting to get my hands on one and I have not. So, last Christmas of 2020, my wife actually got me a $500 gift card for Best Buy to try to get a PlayStation 5. I waited and I waited and I waited and I was never able to get one. So I spent my $500 Best Buy gift card on a surround sound for my man cave down here in the basement of my house. So I bought a new like, big screen TV. I bought a surround sound with a sound bar and speakers and a subwoofer for my little, man cave area and that. But, and then this year, She got me gift cards again. These ones were more generic though, so that I could look anywhere and try to find PlayStation 5. I have not, at this point, gotten my hands on PlayStation 5. My buddy, one of my best friends, actually just he signed up for on Sony's actual website to be put on the list, so to get notified when PlayStation 5 comes out. I actually did the same thing, and he got his notification email today that he can buy PlayStation 5 as of tomorrow. So I'm hoping, fingers crossed, that because I was a couple weeks behind him as far as getting signed up on that list, that I myself am close to getting my hands on a PS5. I've been waiting over a year at this point. The supply shortage, the car shortage, the chip shortage is just bananas at this point. Like, let's get this shit figured out here, folks. You're killing me. You're killing me. You're killing me. Like, let's just get the shit. Let's just get the shit figured out, please, for the love of God. Let me see something here. Why is wait, why? God damn it. Oh, let's see. Why is this being weird? Oh, see Doom. Let's see. So that's the normal version. Okay, so this is Flashpoint. That's a normal Flashpoint. That's the Elite. I'm wondering maybe what I should someone try here. I want to try the Duo, but I want to try it normally. So I haven't done this yet, and I mentioned this in the last video, but I haven't tried the Duo yet, like the normal version of the Duo. I've been doing the event version, which is obviously easier. You don't get as much, you don't get the good stuff. So let's see if I can actually attempt.
Thanks for coming.
Let me see if I can actually attempt the regular version of this and see what I can do here. I want to see what I can do here. All right, I'm ready to go when you are, dude. Bring. So I'm hoping that I'll get a chance at better gear here as well. And your Quantum, I haven't seen someone play Quantum in a while. That's interesting. I'm ready to go. I'm ready to go. I'm ready to go. I'm gonna kill you. I'm gonna kill you. I'm gonna kill you bitches. Kill you and kill you and kill you bitches. Kill you and kill you. Oh, ha 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 ha. Follow John Stewart. Follow John Stewart. All right, let's rock and roll this way. Now, do you get a feat for defeating all the constructs? It kind of seems like you would. Like that would be that seems like that would be something that you would get a feat for. Like, oh, I defeated this construct and this, that, and the other thing and
John Stewart, show me what fears lie just below the surface.
It's really creepy how Sinestro talks there. I like your style there, bud. I like the Superman style he's got going. Sinestro reminds me of like a creepy like pedophile or something. With the way he's talking, the way that he's talking and like the ultraviolet lantern way, it's just weird. I don't know. He's just kind of creeping me out a little bit there. Oh no, 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 no. Oh no, oh no, 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 no. Oh, this is definitely harder. I can tell. I don't know what the fuck's going on here, but... Where's my pet? Where's my pet? Where's my pet? Pet, pet. Where my pet? Where my pet? Where my pet? Pet, pet. Where my pet? Nice. I got a feat. Sweet. Good deal. 304. Ooh, I need the ring. I know I need the ring. That'll definitely help. I know that'll definitely help. And at least I got that stupid. God damn. This guy's good. I like it. Okay, here comes Sinestro. Yep, yeah.
Now we'll face your worst fear, made flesh.
This isn't like you, Sinestro. Serving someone else, sharing power.
A good leader always shares power, and the Perpetua has promised to reward me with even.
Yeah, until you get your ass beat, motherfucker. Okay, here we go, ready? Oh, what the hell? I didn't mean to do that shit. I didn't mean to do that shitballs. Yeah, I didn't mean to do that. Where's Sinestro at? Where's this motherfucker at? Alright, where you at, Sinestro? There you are, motherfucker. Block it. Get him. Oh god, get out of the way. Oh god, there would be no way I'd be able to do this on my own. Like in the normal version, like the event version, sure, but. Shitballs. Where'd you go, Sinestro? Oh, shipples. Oh, shipples. Oh, shipples. Get in there. Nice. Nice. Bitch.
You will still be rewarded, adore my throne and power.
See, so I can get this ring at least real quick here. Yeah, that's definitely better than what I have.
Luther, you bastard.
Yay.
Help me.
That is definitely better than what I had.
I will help you. Clean up the mess.
Cool. Alright, so that got me up to 346. So I need another ring, though, for sure. And I know that the actual gear itself is level 310, so... This stuff is just level 304, I mean, which is fine. You know, that is what it is, but... SpaceX. Or SpaceLax. I automatically see SpaceX and I think of Elon Musk there, I don't know why. I just, you know, it is what it is there. Get him. Come on, baby. Nice. Oh, weapons. Weapon. Damn it. I need. That's what I probably need, too. Source mark, justice token. Exo. Ooh, I got an ingot. An ingot. I like an ingot. But of course, I can't use the ingot because I can't. I don't have my shit leveled up yet. Oh, I didn't do too bad there. I held up pretty nicely there. Alright, I gotta get rid of some of this stuff. So let's see, I can get rid of that and that. By a man who does nothing but sit back and watch. Know that when he inevitably fails, Lex Luthor will be there to pick up the pieces. Okay, that I can. That does nothing for me. I need to. I need to get rid of all this crap. It's time to do an overhaul of my. I need to salvage a bunch of shit. Is what I need to do. Tech revolver. I can collect that style at least. But. I cannot use that ingot because the ingot because I maxed out. Damn it. Alright. So I need to go. But hey, I did it. I did it at least. I did it. I did the normal version. One thing that I'm debating on whether I should use. Well, I guess it doesn't matter. Because, I mean, if you play long enough, it'll even itself out, I'm sure, anyway. But I'm debating on whether I should go ahead and buy some of our pieces. So the normal pieces here is $295. This stuff is $310. I have 66. So how is this even compared? To like, or like the back piece. Where's the back piece? Yeah, see the back piece, yeah. And even like the neck. Where's the neck piece? See, the neck is nowhere even close. See, that would be good. That would be huge. I mean, I think I might save and hold on to these things. I could buy like the boots and I can buy the trinket, something like that. But I think I'm going to save my marks for a while here. What I should do real quick is I want to go salvage all this crap. Unless there was probably a thing. There was probably a like a workstation there that I didn't even realize. So. Let's go salvage. Oh, shit. Damn thing screwed me up. Let's go salvage. Go check it out. Oh, that's the wrong way. Salvage the shit. Holy shitballs, I have a lot. Holy fuck. I didn't realize I had this much crap. Good lord. Ooh, interesting. I'm gonna keep that. Alright, so now I can go down here. Bam, 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 bam. So if this doesn't make a difference in this thing, I don't know what will. Boom, 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 boom. Bam, bam. Hey, I got space again. Kinda, sorta. Power, I don't need them. That I don't need. I'm getting rid of it. These I can keep. Auto sort that shit. Alright, do I have stabilizers? No, I do not. I've got 1,000 loyalty points, though. What should I spend them on? Something useful. Let me see how many. How many of these bad boys do I have? Oh, I only have 80. Okay, that doesn't do anything. Where's Vandal? Vandal Savage, where are you, bitch? Loyalty vendor. I've got 1,000 points. What can I buy?
You should be rewarded for your loyalty.
Well, good. It's about time you realize that. Oh, I could do that. I could buy 10 of these. Legendary Alliance, Ally Favor. This pack is worth 6,500 Ally Favor. Would that be enough? Would that be enough to get Miss Nubia out here? 6,500 enough? Yes, it would be. Well, definitely would be now. I would need one more.
You have excellent taste.
Okay, let's do this. We'll do that. We'll do this. Oh, I didn't even see that. I didn't even pay attention to that. Let's see. Ally, Cyborg, Flash, Zoom. Oh, so you can get... Okay. 70 Source Marks. Let's see. Is there anything else that's... Interesting! Okay, so I didn't even realize this. Holy fuck. There is a ton of stuff down here. So you can really get, like... Well, they have a bunch of the allies there, which is cool. Which I didn't realize. So, like, you can get the Batman Who Laughs for 2,500, but... So that would literally take... You get 500 point loyalty points a month, so that would take 5 months. Gust of Void Wind... Let's see, do they have any of the other, like, catalysts that you need? Exobite, blah, blah, blah. Blah, 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 blah. I literally don't see anything there that I want. Okay, let's go back to the beginning.
The one constant throughout the centuries. Loyalty pays rewards. Remember that.
Alright, I'm gonna do... Fuck it, I'm gonna do 7 of these. Fuck it, fuck it, fuck it. And that way we'll have 7. So what I can do is I can... Whoa, shit. Okay, wait. I gotta do this first, I guess. Where is the... Alright, so we do the pack. Yep. Okay, so let's get Miss Nubia out here. Fortify her. Breakthrough. And now she is level 4. Woohoo. Sweet. All right, so now I can do that. So now that gives us, upon executing a block counter, heal yourself and nearby allies for a percentage of HP. That is sweet. Okay, now I can go into here. And what's up, bud? Okay, I'm making a video right now, so give me a couple minutes, okay? Okay. Let's open up this stuff real quick. Enhanced. Ooh, do I want the ally favor? Or do I want the emblem? Let me take the ally favor. Do I want the... Oh, damn it. Do I want the... okay, so I see. That's 297, so that's nothing. I want to take the Legendary Alliance. There's a bunch of, like, collections and stuff already collected. I don't need that. I'm honestly like taking these just because they're good for... ooh, I want the Enhanced Donna Troy. I'm going to take that. I don't have the regular Donna Troy. Ooh, 10,000! Yeah, buddy! That's huge. Okay, so we'll take the Legendary Alliance, and then we'll open up our last one. And we'll take the other Legendary Alliance. Screw it. Screw it! Bam, I knew it. See? I knew it was going to be a feat. Hell to the yeah. Now we've actually got ourselves a good amount of stuff here, so... Boop, boop, boop. Okay. We can also come back over to our allies here. And we can fortify. Because I have 15,000 experience there. And now, of course, I have enough but the rare alliance, so I can... I will be able to level her up to level 5 here, so that's good. But with that being said, guys, we're going to conclude this episode right here. So thank you guys so much for watching. As always, don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe for more. And until next time, see you soon.